today I'm going to build a drawer for this cabinet, which will be a printer cabinet. The drawer will be 20 inches deep, that is front to back. The opening is 16 inches, however, the drawer will be only 15 because I have to allow a half an inch on both sides for the glides. And the height is 4 3/4 for the opening, so I will make the drawer 4 1/4, allowing 1/4 inch space between the top and the bottom. I like to use Baltic birch plywood, 1/2 inch, because it's very stable, it looks good, and it cuts very easily. I like to use the joinery of finger joints because they're strong. And so today I will cut the plywood into 4 1/4 inch strips in order to make the sides and front and back of the drawer. The face of the drawer, however, will be a separate piece, and it will overlay side to side and a little bit above the top border and a little bit below the bottom border. That way there'll be no gap there. The doors to the cabinet, which I've already built, are raised panel. This is one of the doors, and they'll fit basically right here like that with the other one over here. The purpose of the cabinet is going to be to hold a printer, and it'll have a drawer so to keep supplies in, extra cartridges, etc. And in the bottom will be the place for the paper. So, after I cut the plywood down to 4 1/4 strips, I will set up my Porter cable jig to do the dovetails, and I will continue filming at that point. Okay, I have set up the Porter cable jig or machine, and I've also cut the side pieces and the length pieces to the drawer. Now I will cut the joints using the router. Now this is a critical step because they must fit exactly right. The width is determined by the end and back pieces, which I've already cut to 14 and 15 sixteenths, allowing me 1/16 of an inch leeway. And then the sides I've adjusted by 1/4 of an inch to provide for the dovetail. So let's get started routing this thing. The depth of the router has already been set up, so all I have to do now is Okay. Let's see now if the joint fits. Perfect. When you put glue on that thing, it'll be strong and last forever. See? I get a little bit of splintering because it's plywood, but aside from that, it'll be perfect. Now to do the other three corners. There is the finished box, basically. It's not glued together, it just fitted. However, the measurements turned out to be perfect. 15 wide, 20 deep, and 4 1/4 tall. Now to put the base in, or the bottom of the drawer, I have to use my router table. I have to route a groove on all four pieces to insert the base, and then make sure that they don't show anywhere on the outside. That'll be another step. Okay, I have cut the first groove for the bottom to fit in. It's 7/32 of an inch, because even though the plywood is listed as 1/4, it's only 7/32 thick. I have to do that to all four pieces, making sure that I do not go through the end of the tails, otherwise it'll show. There's the table set up, and I have to change everything just for the little cut.